Hello, Internet, and welcome to another episode of That's All I Have to Say About That. As always, I'm your host, Stephen Mackey. Today we're talking about China, the country that after rampant tax cuts seems to be the largest entity funding the US government. I kid, but seriously, there is no denying that the US is heavily in debt to China, which is what makes this report all the more alarming.
China came out this morning around 5 a.m. with a report saying that they no longer think that U.S. government bonds are attractive as a strategy. This is big. Bonds are down, stocks are down, and the dollar is down. Precious metals are up. So China is the number one holder of U.S. treasuries in the world.
This is not good for America. Although most people watching probably tuned out when they heard the word bonds. And I get it. Bonds aren't sexy. Come on, you know what I mean. Bonds are those things your grandparents buy you and you forget you own. That said, bonds are how the government gets its money. When someone says we owe China money, it's not because Trump got on the phone and called up President Xi and asked him to cut a check for a few billion dollars in order to buy that road we've been wanting. Instead, the Federal Reserve goes out and sells bonds in the open market and China buys them up, along with American citizens and anyone else who wants to give the US money, under the promise that the US government will someday give them back that money with interest. Unfortunately, since no Americans have bought bonds since World War II,
any bonds today? Bonds of freedom, that's what I'm selling, any bonds today? Scrape up the most you can.
Apparently, the message of bonds for freedom really resonated with the Chinese. Either that, or they agreed perfectly with our depiction of the Japanese. Anyways, China, the largest bondholder of US Treasury bonds, has decided to slow or stop buying them. Now this is really throwing the US bond market into some trouble, with CNBC reporting. Last week, yields moved higher after a report suggesting that China may halt or slow its purchase of US Treasuries. Now bond yields moving up are not a good thing if you're a country. It means that nobody wants to buy your bonds. When yields go up, it means that the government has to offer more future money to get people to buy a bond now. And alarmingly, last week we saw 2-year treasury bonds hit their highest yields in 9 years. And, what was going on 9 years ago again? Well, Bush was still president, and demand for government bonds were about as high as demand for a second home. To be fair, many would look at our country's strong leadership under Donald Trump, a man who was quoted as saying, "I would borrow knowing that if the economy crashed, you could make a deal," and say, "Wow, how did those yields not skyrocket beforehand?" Now, I just bring this up to say that maybe China might not be the only thing to blame for this bond trouble. I am very much entering into a more speculative section here for the sake of giving you the ability to contextualize some things that might come up in the news soon. Take it away, Bloomberg TV.
Well, I think it could be a bond bear market, but it's going to be more, I think, a teddy bear market than a grizzly bear market, because the same things that have supported low bond yields here and throughout the world, which is largely monetary policies, have also supported the equity market. And so at some point, you know, when bond yields get up to, 285, perhaps they'll get to 3% in the 10-year area. I don't think so, but they might. Then I think the equity market is going to pick up and take some notice, and I think it's going to be to the benefit of the bond market.
What is that guy talking about? All right, first, and this might sound like a broken record, but this portion is speculation, so don't go putting your retirement into shorting the bond market because a YouTube video made it sound like a good idea. So there are two types of markets, bull and bear markets, because of course the Jordan Belforts of the world would pick two of the most violent animals. It's never going to be a kitten or a bunny market. A bull market is a market where investors are yelling,
"Shut up and take my money!"
and you can sell your bonds with low interest and high prices. Many people say that this problem might signal the end to up to 25 to 30 years of a bull market on bonds, which makes me think, what better time to shut down the government? You know, turn it off and restart it in a few hours, see if it's still broken? Instead, they're saying we finally are potentially entering into a bear bond market, in which people aren't so excited to spend their money anymore. As you can imagine, this is terrible for...
How will Donald Trump deal with the colossal
$20 trillion debt racked up by the federal government.
It just became more expensive to borrow money, making government debt a bigger problem. An even worse problem for the US is that our bonds regularly expire in China. Except instead of collecting on them, they have historically reinvested the money they would have collected back into US government bonds all over again. Just imagine paying off a credit card debt with a different credit card, except in this case, it's all the same credit card. Which, unsurprisingly, is not exactly a great strategy for getting ahead. Although, this would explain why China holds more treasury bills than any other entity. What this also means is that if they don't buy more treasury bonds, they could call on the US to actually pay out some of our trillions of dollars in treasury debts. And unfortunately, it seems as though we don't really have a plan to pay off all these debts, besides acquire more debt. Remind me again why people lost interest in owning our bonds again? We would probably have to sell more bonds in the public market to cover those costs. And in an unfavorable market, that's like donating blood when you're already bleeding out. So why is China thinking about lessening their investment in U.S. bonds?
China, long the largest buyer of U.S. Treasuries, said to be signaling that it might curb its appetite for U.S. debt because of threats that Trump would rewrite trade deals to disadvantage China.
Some speculate that this is China getting revenge on Trump rewriting trade deals that would hurt China. To which I have to say, what? Now, some would argue that the US totally imagines itself in the picture when actually we might not even be in the frame. Some are arguing that this is a chicken and egg situation and that rather than the Chinese investments hurting the bond market is hurting so China wants to invest less in our bonds. Most people are saying it's probably a combination of these two, but I have a feeling that despite the fact that everything seems to connect back to Trump, the latter might have a little more influence. This is a pretty hot off the presses story, and I'm going to continue reporting on it if there are any updates. As always, thank you, and that's all I have to say about that. Hello YouTube, I hope you enjoyed that last video. For more episodes of That's All I Have to Say About That, click here. Please click here to subscribe and like below, and if you're really a fan,